very good morning to WSIS stakeholders from the ITU headquarters in Geneva, Switzerland. We are on the fourth day of the WSIS Forum 2017, and we all welcome you if you are participating on-site or following us remotely. The high-level track of the WSIS Forum 2017 is moderated by high-level track facilitators, and these high-level track facilitators represent the different WSIS stakeholder types that have selected them to be presented out here. That is the governments, private sector, civil society, the technical community, and the academia. I have here with me today the 14 high-level track facilitators who facilitated the different sessions on inclusiveness, on capacity building, on 2030 agenda, and various other interesting sessions which were multi-stakeholder and had a very interesting discussion, and the outcomes are already online on the WSIS Forum website. Good morning, Sharnon. You are representing the technical community here at the WSIS Forum high-level track. What were the main outcomes and the key takeaways of your session?
Okay, first of all, I would like to thank ITU and you all for giving us the opportunity to be here to serve. Basically, most of the times when we are talking about ICT and services, in my particular session, we have been focusing on climate change as well. This is one area that normally we don't focus much on, but we believe this is very important because while we are focusing on making money, while we're focusing on continue developing, let's say, ICTs, it's very important for us to conserve this very important asset that we're living on, which is the planet. So our focus has been, in addition to the other technical areas, to focus on the climate change as well.
Thank you. Focusing on climate change and saving our planet is our joint responsibility. Dr. Grin is representing the private sector, and they had some very interesting panelists on their high-level session. Let's hear more from him about the key trends that were captured during his session.
Thank you, Gitanjali. There are a number of them, and all of them, fortunately, are positive. One which impressed me quite strongly is that now we all, or most countries, moving from building infrastructure to efficient use of it. So it's e-government, e-health, other services are reality now. Second trend, which is very interesting, it's new one, like role of such invention like artificial intelligence or cognitive sciences, which can be available already right now for developing country and can greatly enhance efficiency of and use of knowledge which is everywhere in the world. And maybe the last one which did impress me, it's a presentation from Facebook. So they're going from content providing, also taking care on different ways how to serve underserved population. And it was really impressive. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Grin. Indeed, you had a very interesting panel discussion. The recordings are all available online, so we request you to please go to the WSIS Forum website and listen to the recordings out there. Good morning, Mehvish. You had a very interesting discussion and dialogue, and in fact, a lot of participants as well, joined into your dialogue. Can you please share what happened during your session?
Sure. Thank you, Gitanjali. It was very interesting. We had two panelists present, and the case studies they presented were very interesting and quite disparate. One presented on the National Digital Library in Russia, and the other talked about e-health technologies in Bangladesh. So they were very different. But what was interesting was that they both talked about fostering a more robust information society, and they talked about it in very similar ways. So what they said was whether you're talking about fostering innovation or generating better, more efficient knowledge extraction, it really needs to be drawn from the local context and address local needs, tap into local capacity. And so that was a really interesting discussion. And as you said, the audience got involved and it was wonderful. It was a great dialogue.
Thank you, Mehvish. The most important aspect of WSIS Forum is to be inclusive and to ensure that everybody gets a chance to participate in the dialogues. I have here with me today Ms. Gayatri from APC. She's representing the civil society community. Gayatri, I heard that your panel was extremely multi-stakeholder and there were great discussions around the aspect of linking the WSIS action lines with the SDGs. Can you share some of the key outcomes of your session?
Well, thank you, Gita, and thank you for having us here, because I thought it was a really interesting dialogue. The session that I managed to facilitate related to ICT applications and services, and that was great because it's really ICT applications and services that make the internet relatable and experiential for the people, no? Beyond the infrastructure, and that's what makes the internet real even for the people. And during the session, we had really interesting dialogue between the government as well as the private sector. There were very interesting examples, for instance, in Facebook, how and Bangladesh, where people are mobilizing on Facebook for really interesting initiatives. Like, for instance, people got together to plant 200,000 saplings, clean up the rivers, as well as Bangladesh has also been using these e-filing services that's been saving them a lot of cost in terms of physical infrastructure, but has also been improving their efficiency. And another very important case study we looked at is in the case of Liberia and the very tragic situation of Ebola, and the key role that ICTs played in tackling and to a great extent mitigating that situation. One of the key things that came out of that session, however, is that it was not all one-sided. The participants and the speakers were very aware of and cognizant of the challenges that we have with ICT applications and services, because the two main challenges are that the world is increasingly getting connected, but there are many people that are still unconnected. And as we keep moving to ICT applications, it's very likely that those people who are unconnected will become even more marginalized. So that kind of highlighted the need to push and make sure that they get connected soon. And the second issue that was highlighted was in terms of cybersecurity and the need for states to be able to trust each other when it comes to cybersecurity, but also to have a human rights-based approach to make sure that we put users first and that their privacy and personal data remains safe. So they had very interesting discussions about how to go forward, but civil society was able to present the challenges as they saw it, and the ministers were able to respond to that, and that was great.
Thank you, Gayatri. Indeed, that's the purpose of the WSIS Forum, to provide a equal and just platform for all multi-stakeholders to come and talk together and to forge new partnerships to ensure that ICTs play a crucial role in enabling the Sustainable Development Goals. Andre, good morning. You were the youth representative of the high-level track facilitators. I want to hear more about what you captured as a young person attending the WSIS Forum. What were your key takeaways from your session and from the WSIS Forum in general?
Yeah, I was very surprised in my session, because I feel that I would see a very formal session, but we achieved a very informal dialogue, and we see a very a concern about the not just the regulation problem and a fight between the private sector and the public sector, but a real concern about the multi-stakeholder model and a concern about the necessity about the change and the urgency of the question about the digital divide and about other divides, about the gender divide, about the youth divide. So I think that it was a great experience to be here in the WSIS Forum and represent the youth. It was a great step in this forum. So it was a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you. The pleasure is all ours, and we hope that we will continue to engage with the youth. During this WSIS Forum, we had students from different schools and universities of not only Switzerland, but all over the world participating in the hackathon, and also a virtual reality experience that connected the schools in Switzerland with various other schools in parts of the world. Good morning, Jessica. Can you share some key takeaways from your very interesting high-level session?
Sure, thank you, and thanks for this opportunity to be a high-level track facilitator. My session was on the knowledge society, capacity and e-learning, and some of the takeaways were that there's been a lot of progress in how to extend learning opportunities using digital technologies, but there are still some challenges, particularly with literacy, both digital literacy and traditional literacy. Some of the solutions that were sort of proposed were that by expanding digital literacy, sometimes traditional literacy can also make progress. Another key takeaway was that we need to be thinking about new technologies like big data, artificial intelligence, and how they can be integrated into capacity building and e-learning and the building of knowledge societies, as along with smart cities as learning environments and centers of excellence, where as long as there's some horizontal learning that takes place between these smart cities, that this would be sort of a next step in how we continue to build the knowledge society.
Thank you, Jessica. Dr. Habib's session was the last one, in fact, on Tuesday. And even though it was the last session, I could see the excitement and the all the participants were engrossed because it was such an interesting topic and such an excellent discussion had emerged in that session. Dr. Habib, could you please share some key challenges and opportunities that were shared in your session?
Thank you. Good morning. This is my first time in the WSIS Forum, and as academia member, it was very exciting opportunity to discuss and make some cooperation, and it was a great dialogue with ministers from Iran, from Uganda, from Vietnam, and representative from Mexico, Moldova, and 50 more ventures. The speakers highlights the need to focus more on the how we can solve the problems of bridging of digital divides, and they also present their plan for the next years and the new strategies that they should make plan. What I also liked in this forum, in the WSIS forum, it is mainly the international networking. Thanks for ITU for inviting me to this forum, and congratulations for the success of WSIS Forum 2017.
Thank you, Dr. Habib. You were also a mentor at the hackathon, Hack for Health, on the first day of the WSIS Forum. How was it to have so many young people here at the WSIS Forum and develop applications in the area of e-health?
Yeah, it was very amazing. 2 days just before the WSIS Forum. During more than 24 hours continue time, the teams make a great challenge and presented some great work projects, and I hope that they will continue to develop them, and congratulations for the winners who are from Poland, from Norway, and from Tunisia.
Thank you very much. Hello, Suchita. Suchita was moderating the panel on gender mainstreaming. And in fact, one of the achievements of this WSIS Forum was a lot of women speakers, panelists. In fact, even in the participation, there's an increased participation from women at the WSIS Forum. This is a great thing to see. And let's hear more from Suchita, because she had an excellent panel on gender mainstreaming and ICTs.
Thank you so much, Gitanjali, and thank you so much for having me here. My panel was absolutely fascinating. So I think they also opened by speaking about the WSIS Forum itself and how you're making strides in including women participation. I think 38% this year with a targeted 50% in the years to come. I think the HLTFs also have nearly 50-50 participation, but they also highlighted that there are many parts of the world that have much more severe problems. The gender digital gap is rising in LDCs. More developed countries also have fairly significant problems when it comes to equal pay for equal work. There were lots of really interesting ideas about how to improve that, but the challenges remain: the barriers to education, lack of access, stereotypical representations, tokenism, and just a whole host of others. Some particularly interesting ideas that I thought came out of the discussion were, the increase of auditing of programs that are introduced, promoting personal branding for women in earlier career stages so that they can progress well through the stages. Bridging the skill gap is, of course, incredibly important. The encouraging note that I think everyone struck was that gender mainstreaming is actually at the top of a lot of national and global agendas right now. So there's a whole lot of scope to actually make positive change going forward. I'm hoping we get to see that sometime soon.
Thank you very much, Suchita. Today we heard from all the high-level track facilitators who were nominated to represent their different stakeholder types here at the WSIS Forum 2017. They did an excellent job of capturing the key trends, the opportunities, the challenges, and the key linkages of their session with the Sustainable Development Goals at their respective high-level policy sessions. We thank you for listening in, and we hope you enjoy the next 2 days of the WSIS Forum 2017. Thank you very much.